Welcome back. I'm Christian Esquera. In 2019, the Estrada family was supposed to mark 50 years since Joseph Estrada built the dynasty in San Juan City. But in the elections earlier that year, the family lost power, not just in San Juan, but also in the capital city of Manila, where then-Mayor Joseph Estrada sought to expand the dynasty. Worse, his two sons both lost in the senatorial election that year. Clearly, the Estradas were wiped out, save for a lone councilor who won in San Juan. Tonight, we'll speak with the man who ended the Estrada dynasty in San Juan. I'd like to welcome to the program San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora. Good evening, sir, and thank you for joining us tonight on the program.
Good evening, Christian, and thanks for having me again.
Okay, in 2019, I remember you and a few other politicians, relatively young as you are, were described as dynasty slayers. In your case, the dynasty which ended was that of the Estradas. Now, looking, going into the 2022 elections, would you say that somehow the Estradas are done? There's no going back for them as far as it is concerned, as far as San Juan is concerned.
Christian, at the glance, we can see that there is no Estrada in the national government. There's no Estrada in the local government except for one councillor in San Juan. And yes, they were wiped out in 2019, but again, they are trying to make a comeback. In fact, I was anticipating that one of them may run here in San Juan, but again, they decided to both run in the Senate. So let's see how that works out. But in terms of San Juan, I would like to say that it seems like everything is under control. They are trying to win a congressional seat, and let's see. At the end of the day, it will be the constituents who will make the final decision.
So in your case, your opponent is someone identified with the Estradas as well, right? See, attorney June Osman. But how serious really is this challenge? And were you surprised that no one, see JB Harrison or Jingo Estrada, basically challenged you for the mayoralty?
Christian, first of all, I don't think Junis Osman is an attorney. He was a former Kagawad, and he ran for barangay captain of Barangay Batis a few years ago and lost. He is a very loyal supporter of former Senator Jingo Estrada. If you're asking me, am I surprised that no one ran against me? Actually, I was anticipating that one of them would. But again, looking at the family dynamics, you would understand, especially someone like me who has been with them for a very, very long time. I understand the family politics involved in the Estrada family. And again, I was anticipating that one of them may run against me or run for Congress. But looking at other factors, no one would also want to give the other one an advantage. Because if one had slid down to San Juan, that would have paved the way for the other's senatorial bid. So I guess no one wanted to give way also. And it gives us a glimpse of the relationship of the two brothers.
You also get the sense that somehow there could be a repeat of the 2019 result, that both of them lost because no one wanted to give way. Ngayon, sabay na naman sila tumatakbo.
And you know what? Just like what you said, akala ko natuto na rin sila noong 2019. No? Maybe they think they can pull it off this time. But again, the previous experience showed that it's very hard for them to win if they are two. Imagine there are only 12 Senate seats. Would our voters give two seats to two brothers? No? Siyempre, marami rin namang ibang mga pwedeng pagpilian. No? Maraming mga qualified, maraming comebacking. Maraming dati naglingkod bilang senador na babalik. No? So hindi ganun kadali yan. And I guess surveys would show na hindi nga ganun ang case ngayon. Let's see. Christian, I don't want to preempt. No? Siyempre, botante pa rin ang pipili dyan. But what will be hard for them is both of them are not incumbents. No? Sanay sila na merong local government. No? Sanay sila may San Juan, sanay sila may Manila, sanay sila ang incumbent senators. Right now, lahat yan wala sa kanila. And that is the reality.
Okay. When you won in 2019 and defeated Estradas, one concern which was often mentioned at that time was that you could be building your own dynasty in San Juan. Is that the case now?
Christian, alam mo, I always believe, no? Ang botante pa rin ang nagdedesisyon. No? We offer ourselves to the electorate. We offer our programs. We offer everything that we have done. If they feel that we can serve our city well, then it's their choice. Itong nakarang 2.5 years, Christian, ano ang naranasan ng San Juan? For the first time, ang mayor at ang congressman ay tunay na magkakampi. When I say tunay na magkakampi, that means the local government does not block any of the congressman's infrastructure projects, social services, lahat ng funding from the national government ay talagang umaabot sa mamamayan. Dati kasi, honestly, naranasan ko to when I was vice mayor and my father was congressman, maraming mga projects ng aking ama ay hinaharang ng dating administrasyon. Imbis na mapakinabangan ng ating mga mamamayan, hinaharang ang mga ito. Infrastructure projects that were not allowed to be constructed, yung social funds na hindi na i-implement on the ground. Dahil, syempre, dahil sa politika, feeling nila, oh, nasasapawan sila ng congressman, nasasapawan sila ng mga Zamora. So maraming pondong hindi umabot sa ating mamamayan. Now, itong nakaraang 2.5 years, talagang naranasan ng San Juan yung all-out support ng congressman through the national government. In fact, what I would always say to our constituents, yung funds ng local government plus the funds of the national government, malaking pondo being shared by a small constituency in San Juan. Kaya ang dami natin nagagawa. We are now building 2 high-rise NCT public housing buildings. One is 22 stories, one is 23 stories. All of them will have 28 square meters of housing units. Ongoing na yan. Sabi ng kalabang ko dati, sabi ng nakaraang administrasyon, imposible raw mangyari. Ngayon, nagsisimula na. Right now, Christian, all our public school students, one is to one, meron silang kanya-kanya mga tablets for online education. Lahat may internet connection sa bahay, fiber optic yan for online education. Sabi ng nakaraang administrasyon, imposible raw yan. So ang dami natin nagagawa ngayon.
In fiber optic, yes. Is free?
Yes, that's free.
Is this the one that was established in cooperation with the DICT?
O iba pa? Ang pre-provide, Christian, ng DICT ay yung mga tablets. We were selected as the pilot city for the free Wi-Fi for all program. And part of this was the provision of tablets to all public school students. So dahil ang public school students namin ay nakatanggap ng libreng gadgets from the DICT, these are tablets. And we have a pilot school naman na ang natanggap nila ay laptops. Yung pondong natipid namin through our special education fund, binuhos naman natin sa fiber optic internet connection for online education.
This sa schools for, or sa mga households?
Sa households. Almost 7,000 households kinabitan ng kanya-kanyang modems.
So libre?
For the first time. Yes, libre, Christian. Libre.
Okay.
At ito yung ginagamit na online learning platform ngayon sa online education. So we have our own learning management system. Doon sila nag-aaral, doon sila nag-exam, doon sila nag-lecture.
Sige. And Mayor, hihimayin natin iba pa mga programa that you have in store in case you get re-elected. Pero I'd like to ask an additional question dun sa sinabi niyo. Basically, seamless yung working relations between you and the congressman. Pero correct. That's not surprising kasi mag-ama kayo eh, no?
Correct, correct.
Baka naman isipin ng iba na nadinig yung argument nyo. So dapat talaga magkamag-anak para maging seamless ang working relations. And won't that be an argument that could further perpetuate political dynasties? Kasi ganito rin man that same argument I've heard before, no? At dyan din lumaki yung Estrada dynasty, di ba?
Yes, Christian. Hindi naman kinakailangan mag-ama, magkapatid. But the fact is, ang San Juan, merong dalawang pamilya na naglalaban in terms of political control. No? And siguro alam naman natin yan, no? Zamora versus Estrada. Ang gusto mangyari ng ating constituents ay yung continuity ng naranasan nila. Now, if the Estradas will put up a fight, for instance, for mayor, for Congress, they feel that it has to be the Zamoras who will also go up against them or else babalik lang ang Estrada. Ganyan ang local political situation dito eh. And we did a survey, myself against Senator Jinggoy, former Senator Jinggoy, myself against former Senator JB. And based on a survey, ang aking rating ay 83%. Ang kanilang rating ay 13% with 4% undecided.
Pareho sila 13%?
Doon mo makikita, yes, it's not about the personality, it's about the brand, meaning Zamora o Estrada. And for the first time, Christian, in 50 years, no, there is now a basis of comparison. Kasi dati wala naman comparison. Parang okay, Estrada, 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 for 5 decades, puro Estrada. Ngayon lang sila nakaranas ng iba. And I would like to believe that in the first 2.5 years of our term, nakita nila yung kaibahan. Later, I can enumerate these changes.
Okay, isa-isa natin yan. Let's just get this over with, the idea of a looming Zamora dynasty. So your father was termed out, no? So tapos na siya. And it's your sister running for Congress.
Yes.
In the Congressional District of San Juan. So what makes that different from what the Estradas did before?
Well, ang difference...
Kumanalo kayo pareho, so Zamora pareho uli yung nakaupo.
Correct, Christian. Pero anong naging kaibahan? Nung nagsimula ang Estradas, 1969 when the former president won, pinasa ng pinasa yan from one family member to another. Now, my father was their congressman. In fact, almost all of them, naging mayor ng father ko when he was serving as congressman. Kaya lang, in the course of all of these decades, napabayaan nilang San Juan. Maraming bagay na dapat, napaganda nila. All throughout the years, imagine, they had the former president, they had several senators. Ang dami nilang opportunities noon na pagandahin ng San Juan with the political clout and authority they had then. Kaya lang, hindi nila ito nagawa. So ano nangyari sa San Juan? Naging stagnant. No? Parang hanggang doon na lang, naiwanan ng ibang mga lungsod. No? So people really sought for the change. At with all modesty aside now, when people talk about San Juan, no? We are oftentimes the benchmark sa vaccination, number one tayo sa buong Pilipinas. No? Lumalabas tayo sa news for good news. Dati, pag pinapag-usapan ng San Juan, plunder, corruption, wetting. Yeah, totoo naman. I'm not lying. Ngayon, we have put back San Juan in the map in a good way. And people appreciate this.
Okay. Yung challenge coming from the Estradas now. So, yung isang Estrada, tumatakbo para labanan yung sister niya. No? Then basically, there's no Estrada or Ejercito challenging you. How strong is that challenge on the part of your sister?
Well, given the surveys that we have, yung opponent ng kapatid ko ay 17% lang. And my sister is doing 79%. My sister is a lawyer. She finished law in the University of the Philippines. She was also a cum laude. So, aral siya. Talking about being a congresswoman, kinakailangan, naintindihan mo ang batas. No? At being a lawyer, she understands the law. She has also been handling my father's congressional district office for 3 years now. So I believe that she is very much prepared to be the next congresswoman.
Okay, in case you get reelected, so what can your constituents expect from you in your second term?
Christian, ang priority natin talaga public health. No? We are still facing a pandemic. Although mababa na nga ang bilang ng mga kaso natin, we are down to just 34 active cases. Here in San Juan, we are trying our best to get this down to zero, but it's still about public health and also about economic recovery. No, marami tayong mga infrastructure projects na medyo na-delay dahil most of our funding were really realigned to COVID response and interventions. Mahaba ang mga naging lockdown, that means infrastructure projects natigil. So we will continue all of these. We will sustain everything that we have achieved and gained during the last 2.5 years. No, marami pa tayong dapat gawin. Ngunit nagkaroon na ng glimpse, no, ang San Juan sa pagbabago. In fact, ang aming trust talaga is makabagong San Juan, Christian.
Can you give us a glimpse of your post-COVID recovery plan? Kasi I remember in a previous conversation we had, sinabi niyo gano'ng kalaki ibinagsak ng revenue collection ng San Juan, which is also the case in other LGUs. No? So, what can they expect for the next 3 years given this this dip in funding?
Christian, bumaba ng 300 million yung budget natin for 2021 compared to 2.5 billion in 2020. We had to cut it down to 2.2 billion. But since yung Mandanas law ay take effect na nga next year, no? Medyo malaking tulong ito sapagkat that's another additional 200 million pesos para sa atin through this law. Now, since we are under alert level already and we are seeing that cases are remaining to be low, we are really hoping for businesses to bounce back in 2022. Napakarami nating ginagawang interventions for them. In fact, we, number one, we made sure all employees of businesses here in San Juan have been fully vaccinated. Ako mismo nag-iikot sa mga negosyo, sa mga commercial areas, installing stickers stating that they are 100% vaccinated. Nagkakabit kami ng safety seal. Meron tayong vaccine incentive program that gives discounts to people who show vaccination cards. In fact, we are now about to be issued a certificate by the NVOC, yung National Vaccine Operations Center, that we have achieved the vaccination beyond 70% for senior citizens and the persons with comorbidities, which will allow us an additional 20% in the existing operational capacity. So mas mapupuno natin yung mga business establishments dahil mataas ng vaccination rate ng San Juan. We also gave them a lot of leeway in terms of tax payments. Marami tayong binigay na extension sa kanila. Noong naintindihan natin na hirap magbayad ng real property tax and business tax. So parati tayong nagbibigay ng extensions and incentives, na discounts for early payments. All of these will really be a big help entering into 2022.
Okay. Yung as a final point, no? So basically, there's a comparison now, as you said, between the Estrada kind of governance over the past 50 years, although technically almost 50 years, because they were supposed to celebrate their half a century of dynasty.
Hindi sila mabot ng golden anniversary. Hanggang 49 point something.
Yeah, because they got defeated in the May 2019 elections. No? In this case, what would you consider as your signature or the difference in terms of governance approach that you were able to show over the past 2.5 years that could compare or differentiate you from the kind of governance or politics that Estrada's had for almost 50 years? Kasi ang context po ng question na ito is that while you are basically young, you're considered as a dynasty slayer in 2019, you also were part of the other political dynasty, so to speak, in the city. So what was the difference? What has been the difference?
Christian, siguro ang pinaka main difference ko as a mayor, no? Ako, I'm a very hands-on micromanager. Talagang as mayor, honestly, it helps me a lot. Yung alam mo lahat ng nangyayari araw-araw. There's nothing wrong with being OC about this. Dapat nga OC ka kung mayor ka eh. Kasi down to the smallest detail ng pagpapatakbo ng city mo, dapat alam mo. Dapat talagang lahat ng pangangailangan. Just example lang, Christian, yung vaccination program. I have Viber group specific for vaccine operations, anong number ng vaccinees for today, yung confirmatory text, all of these, no? To ensure that there will always be a smooth flow during our vaccination program. These small details na maaring tinitake for granted ng ibang mayor dati. No? Ako, I really am on the ground. I do my inspections. I understand everything that's happening. Lahat yan, inaalam ko, lahat, iniintindi ko, lahat, inaaral ko. And it allows me to perform at an optimum level because I know everything that's happening. I don't have to be coached. Ano? Walang magbubulong sa akin na ganito, ganyan. Because kahit nakapikit ako, I know what's happening in my city. And it helps a lot. No? As a mayor, dapat ganyan. No? Alam mo lahat ng nangyayari, lahat ng problema.
Okay. Mayor Francis Zamora, thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for answering our questions.
Thank you very much, Christian.
So that's it for tonight. This has been your host, Christian Esguerra. You can watch this episode again on I Want TFC or listen to our podcast on Spotify. Now for recaps and other exclusive content, subscribe to the ANC YouTube channel and catch up with us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you again on Monday after the fact.